survey says it's 6 o'clock, time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
We've asked Australia some big questions, and tonight the family who can best guess the answers will have the chance to win $10,000 and a brand new car. So time to meet our families. First up, would you please welcome back our carryover champs who are here on their second night in a row from Victoria. It's the Parnaby family. Hi, Sharon. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Remind Australia who's on board this dynamic team of yours.
I have my husband Brad, my nephew Travis, and my niece Cassie.
Lovely. And ready to take it on tonight from Victoria. Let's hear it from the Riansyah family. Ryan, welcome.
Thank you.
Who's on board your team?
I've got my sister Marcel, my nephew Lukman, and my partner in crime twin, my wife.
Your partner in crime and also my wife. Twin, down the end where she's safer. Yeah. Right, are you ready to do this? Okay, teams, team captains, round one, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name an activity where you shut your eyes before you do it.
Ryan? Sleeping.
Yeah. It's a logical answer. And the top answer. They're going to play. Oh, Marcel,
hi.
Welcome. You ready to rock?
Yeah, definitely.
Name an activity where you shut your eyes before you do it.
Hide and seek.
Hide and seek. Let's see if it's on the board. Nice work. Nice work. Hi. Lukman, how are you?
Good, thanks. How are you?
You're the party animal of the family, are you?
Ooh.
I can hear. I've heard you do a pretty mean robot.
Ah, a little bit.
Do you do a mean robot? Do we want to see the mean robot? Go on, Lukman. Oh, yeah!
I don't know about that one, but
it's really good. You got some style, man. I like it.
Thank you.
Name an activity where you shut your eyes before you do it.
I'd say jump it from a height. Close my eyes first.
You close your eyes before you jump.
Yep.
Oh. First strike, I'm afraid. Early days. Hey, twin, how are you?
Good.
Lovely to see you.
You too.
Name an activity where you shut your eyes before you do it, twin.
Diving.
Yeah.
Off a platform,
You shut your eyes and hope for the best. Good work. We're playing well so far, Ryan.
Yes.
Of course, you knew they would, because that's why your hand selected them, yeah?
That's right.
What was the decision about coming on board for the show?
I just love Family Feud.
Do you?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah, we feud all the time.
That's funny, because our family feuds. Let's go on the show. Name an activity where you shut your eyes before you do it.
Bungee jumping.
Bungee jumping, bungee jumping. I like that. Second strike, I'm afraid. The Parnabys could steal here, Marcel.
Yes.
Name an activity where you shut your eyes before you do it.
Okay, I'm going to go with something similar to my first answer. Probably say peekaboo.
Peekaboo.
Yeah.
Let's see if it's on the board. That's 3 strikes over to the Parnabys. Hey, Cassie, what would you say?
I'm going to go with meditation.
Travis.
Pray.
Brad.
Big sloppy kiss.
Sharon.
Yeah, I'll go with a big sloppy kiss.
Yeah, we do. You close your eyes before a big sloppy patcheroony. Skydive, scary rides, 46-0. Early days though, and you know what, Parnabys? If you're going to win for 5 nights in a row, you'll be taking home the amazing all-new Mitsubishi Outlander. This family SUV seats 5 comfortably. It's packed with features including touchscreen audio, CVT auto with paddle shift, eco-drive support and 18-inch alloy wheels. Doesn't it look good? Now, here's a question for everybody playing along at home. I want the top answer to this one. Name the messiest room in your house. Let's compare answers when we come back. Don't go anywhere, I'm Family Feud. Two families are competing for the chance to win $10,000. Now, before the break, I asked, name the messiest room in your house. The top answer was...
Bedroom!
Well done. done, everybody. Righto, Brad, Marcel, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name something that should be hung up. Brad.
Washing.
Washing should be hung up. Nice. Marcel?
Your clothes.
Your clothes should always be hung up. Pass or play? Well done. Are you going to play? Okay, sure. Not only dance, but apparently you do wonderful impersonations as well, Lookman.
Just one good one.
Oh, yeah? Of what?
Horse.
You can do a good horse.
Good horse. Want me to do one?
We want to hear that too, though. Yeah. Ready?
All right, I'm ready.
Yeah, go.
No, hold on.
There's a fair bit of saliva that went both this way and that way.
I'm sorry.
But it was pretty accurate. How often would you bring out the GG?
When I meet a new girl or something like that. I'm joking.
Is that how you kiss, Lookman?
No.
Name something that should be hung up.
I hang up my pictures at home.
Good answer. Twin.
Yes.
You know what I find is really hot in a girl?
What?
The ability to reverse park. Is that your thing?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah, most people don't like it, but I love it, yeah.
That is so cool. We could get along very well. I love cars.
I love reversing.
Name something that should be hung up.
I would say, like, pots and pans in your kitchen.
Oh, yeah, you hang up your pots and pans. Yeah. First try. Good try, though. Ryan, fun family.
Yes, it is.
You're proud of them so far?
Yes, I am.
You're enjoying yourself, aren't you? You're shifting your weight, you're all excited, you're smiling. You couldn't smile any harder.
No, this is me naturally.
Just always having a good time.
Yeah. Even when I'm delivering bad news.
Like what?
Like, for example, in my line of work, I normally deliver bad news to my clients. And,
What is it you do?
I don't know.
Now, what is your job?
I'm a customs broker.
Oh, you're a customs broker?
Yes. Yeah.
So what does that involve?
Import and export.
So you deliver bad news like... Yeah.
Like when something's in storage.
Yeah.
And you have to pay a lot of money.
Oh, and you come along and go, sorry, you're going to have to pay a fortune.
Look on the bright side.
Look on the bright side. It's really going to hurt you financially. Yeah, that's awesome. You can, like, just deliver my phone bill every time it comes to my house. I feel better.
Can I?
Yeah.
Let's do that.
Yeah. I like Ryan. Name something that should be hung up.
A telephone needs to be hung up.
Let's see. Always this crazy?
All the time.
Name something that should be hung up.
I'm thinking a clock.
A clock's got to go on the wall.
Yeah.
Second strike. Right out of the Parnabys could steal. It's up to you, Lookman.
On a rainy day, I hang up my coat.
You hang up your coat.
Yeah.
You guys are keeping yourself in the game here. You're currently trail, but there's only 2 left on the board, Twin. Let's knock one out. Name something that should be hung up.
Or in the bathroom, you hang up your towels.
You hang up your towels. That's awesome. Oh, no! Righto, Parnabys, yet another chance to steal. Cassie, what would you say?
I'm going to go with shirt.
Travis.
I think a suit, Grant.
Excellent. Brad.
Yeah, we're looking at dress.
Dress? A nice variation on a similar theme there, Sharon.
Yeah,
so you're the boss here. You're the elected captain.
Yep. I first thought, in my mind, I thought shirt. So I'll go with it.
You hang up your shirt for the steal?
Let's just do it.
Give me shirt on the board. No! Righto, gets one! The Riansyah family are in the game! Remaining answers! Dress!
Suit!
Was that yours, Travis? They should have listened, shouldn't they, Travis? They should have listened. Rightio, it's 46. The Riansyah's moving to the lead on 72 right now. And Lookman's happy with that too. What a cool cat he is. Double points time, everybody, for this next question. So, Travis, Lookman, let's play.
Good luck.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something you'd put in a box.
Wow, that was fast.
Shoes?
Shoes in a box. Curtis.
Gift, Grant.
You put a gift in a box. Nice work. Something you put in a box.
I'm going to go with maybe some photos in a box.
Yeah, you collect your photos, you store them in a box.
Yes.
Photos. Ooh, first try. Sharon. Something you put in a box.
Jewellery.
Jewellery?
Yeah.
A jewellery box.
A jewellery box.
Top answer. For a man who's wearing a pink shirt, where do you put your jewellery, Brad?
Oh, wow.
Oh, it's peach.
It's peach. Peach. Yes,
peach.
awful, but the only thing that comes to mind, a body.
You put a... you put a body in the box.
It's a coffin, it's a box.
It's, yeah, it is, it is. That is, that is, that is true. Yeah. I'm scared right now, Brad.
I know.
Travis, name something you'd put in a box.
Thinking mementos, trinkets, Grant.
Trinkets or mementos? Second strike. The rain stars could steal this back. Cassie.
I'm going to go with toiletries.
Toiletries?
Yep.
That's 3 strikes. Sorry to break up the rain star huddle. Twin.
I'm thinking flowers. I love receiving flowers in a box.
Nice. Lookman.
I was going to say cake.
Marcel.
I was going to say tools.
Tools. Yeah. Toolbox. Ryan.
I think I'll go with my sister on this one. Tools.
Tools?
Tools.
For the steal? Show me tools! Oh, no! The Parnabys get the points! That was a tough one. Remaining answers.
Chocolate. Toys. Money.
Or money in a money box. Of course you would. So, it's 72 to the Parnabys 140. They take back control of the game right now. Look, we know you like watching Family Feud, then why not play along with our official Family Feud game? Just head to 10play and look up Family Feud for all the highlights and the fun from behind the scenes right here on set as well. After the break, anybody can win this, you know why? It's triple points time. We'll see you after this right here on Family Feud. Two families are competing for the chance to win $10,000. Now, before the break, I asked, name the messiest room in your house. The top answer was...
bedroom!
Well done, everybody. Righto. Brad, Marcel, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name something that should be hung up. Brad.
Washing.
Washing should be hung up. Nice. Marcel?
Your clothes.
Your clothes should always be hung up. Pass or play? Well done.
We'll play.
Are you going to play? OK, good. Not only dance, but apparently you do wonderful impersonations as well, Lookman.
Just one good one.
Oh, yeah? What, of what?
Horse.
You can do a good horse.
Good horse.
We want to hear that too, though. Ready?
All right, I'm ready.
Yeah, go.
No, hold on.
That's good. Like, it was a fair bit of saliva that went both this way and that way.
I'm sorry.
But it was pretty accurate. How often would you bring out the GG?
When I meet a new girl or something like that.
I'm joking. Is that how you kiss, Lookman?
No, I don't. No.
Name something that should be hung up.
I hang up my pictures at home.
Good answer. Twin.
Yes.
You know what I find is really hot in a girl?
What?
The ability to reverse park.
Is
that your thing?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah, most people don't like it, but I love it, yeah.
That is so cool. We could get along very well. I love cars.
I love reversing.
Name something that should be hung up.
I would say, like, pots and pans in your kitchen.
Oh, yeah, you hang up your pots and pans.
Yeah.
Go first try. Good try, though.
Ryan, fun family.
Yes, it is.
You proud of them so far?
Yes, I am.
You're enjoying yourself, aren't you? You're shifting your weight, you're all excited, you're smiling. You couldn't smile any harder.
No, this is me naturally.
Just always having a good time.
Yeah. Even when I'm delivering bad news.
Like what?
Like, for example, in my line of work, I normally deliver bad news to my clients. And,
What is it you do?
I don't know.
Now, what is your job?
I'm a customs broker.
Oh, you're a customs broker?
Yes. Yeah.
So what does that involve?
Import and export.
So you deliver bad news like... Yeah.
Like when something's in storage and you have to pay a lot of money.
Oh, and you come along and go, sorry, you're going to have to pay a fortune.
Look on the bright side.
Look on the bright side. It's really going to hurt you financially. Yeah, that's awesome. You could, like, just deliver my phone bill every time it comes to my house. I'd feel better.
Can I?
Yeah. Let's do that.
Yeah.
I like Ryan. Name something that should be hung up.
A telephone needs to be hung up.
Let's see. Yeah. You're always this crazy?
All the time.
Name something that should be hung up.
I'm thinking a clock.
A clock's got to go on the wall.
Yeah.
Second strike. Right out of the Parnaby's could steal. It's up to you, Lookman.
On a rainy day, I'd hang up my coat.
You hang up your coat.
Yeah.
You guys are keeping yourself in the game here. You're currently trail, but there's only two left on the board, twin. Let's knock one out. Name something that should be hung up.
Or in the bathroom, you hang up your towel.
You hang up your towel. That's awesome. Oh, no! Righto, Parnaby's. Yet another chance to steal. Cassie, what would you say?
I'm going to go with shirt.
Travis.
I think it's suit, Grant.
Excellent. Brad.
Yeah, we're looking at dress.
Dress? A nice variation on a similar theme there, Sharon.
Yeah,
so you're the boss here. You're the elected captain.
Yep. I first thought in my mind, I thought shirt. So I'll go with it.
You hang up your shirt for the steal?
Let's just do it.
Give me shirt on the board. No! Righto, he gets one. The Riansyah family are in the game. Remaining answers. They should have listened, shouldn't they, Travis? They should have listened. Rightio, it's 46. The Riansyah's moving to the lead on 72 right now. And Lookman's happy with that too. What a cool cat he is. Double points time, everybody, for this next question. So, Travis, Lookman, let's play.
Good luck.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something you'd put in a box. Wow, that was fast.
Shoes?
Shoes in a box. Travis.
Gift, Grant.
You put a gift in a box. Nice work. Something you put in a box.
I'm going to go with maybe some photos in a box.
Yeah, you collect your photos and you store them in a box.
Yes.
Photos. Ooh, first try. Sharon. Something you put in a box.
Jewelry.
Yep. A jewelry box.
A jewelry box.
Top answer. For a man who's wearing a pink shirt, where do you put your jewelry, Brad?
Oh, wow.
Oh, it's peach.
It's peach. Peach. Yes,
peach.
awful, but the only thing that comes to mind, a body.
You put a... Put a body in the box.
Yeah, it's a coffin, it's a box.
It is. That is true. Yeah. I'm scared right now, Brad.
I know. Yes!
Travis, name something you'd put in a box.
Thinking mementos, trinkets, Grant.
Trinkets or mementos? Second strike. The rain sales could steal this back. Cassie.
I'm going to go with toiletries.
Toiletries?
Yep.
That's three strikes. Sorry to break up the Riansyah huddle. Twin.
I'm thinking flowers. I love receiving flowers in a box.
Nice. Lookman.
I was going to say cake.
Marcel.
I was going to say tools.
Tools. Yeah. Toolbox. Ryan.
I think I'll go with my sister on this one. Tools.
Tools?
Tools.
For the steal?
Show me tools! Oh, no! The Parnabys get the points! That was a tough one. Remaining answers. Of course you would. So it's 72 to the Parnaby's 140. They take back control of the game right now. Look, we know you like watching Family Feud, then why not play along with our official Family Feud game? Just head to 10play and look up Family Feud for all the highlights and the fun from behind the scenes right here on set as well. After the break, anybody can win this, you know why? It's triple points time. We'll see you after this right here on Family Feud. Now, the scores are 72 to the Parnabys are leading. Our carryover champs have it right now on 140, but the family who gets to 300 points in this round could win $10,000. And right now, we're playing for triple points, so it's wide open, OK? So, Cassie, Twin, let's play.
Hi, good luck.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name something a beauty pageant contestant might wear. Darcy.
A tiara.
A tiara. Quinn?
A sash.
A sash. Good. Ooh. Pass or play, Cassie?
We're playing.
They're going to play. Name something a beauty pageant contestant might wear.
A beautiful dress.
A beautiful dress. There it is. Ever been in a beauty contest?
Well, actually, I have, actually. I was Master Fairway in grade 5.
Really?
I was, at my primary school.
Wow. And how did it go?
I won.
You're
I won
good.
Master Fairway. I got the sash, the whole bit.
You got the whole deal.
The whole deal.
It's nice, isn't it?
It
when
is.
When you're up front and centre and everybody's
right.
admiring your work.
Exactly.
Lovely. Like they are now. Are you admiring his work? Everybody's still got it. Still got it. Name something a beauty pageant contestant might wear.
Well, unlike when I was in grade 5, Grant, I wouldn't be wearing a bikini, which is, I think, what they wear.
Show me bikini on the board. Not the only person as well, I hear.
Yeah, that's true, Grant. I was actually best in show as a baby at the shopping centre.
Was that your first and last time you've ever competed in a competition like that?
Look, it probably was. I went out on top, so... Yeah.
One comp, one win.
Yeah, yeah.
Walk away.
Exactly.
Walk away. Name something a beauty pageant contestant might wear.
I think they might wear, to beautify themselves, makeup.
Makeup! Best in show. It's a cool title. Cassie.
Well, something I can't live without is high heels.
Let's see. Nice work. Sharon, name something a beauty pageant contestant might wear.
They wear the cloak, you know, when they're crowned. They put the big cloak around them.
A cloak?
Yeah, you know...
Thingy when, that goes
yeah,
on them after the big announcement.
Yeah.
The I've won cloak!
Yeah.
Is that on the board? First strike. Brad.
How about a smile?
You wear? I like that answer. Because you've got to have a good beamy white smile, don't you? Everyone yeah. likes a nice smile! Oh. Two strikes. Look at that huddle over there. No, don't let me interrupt you. This is a tight one tonight, Travis. I don't know how this one's going to end. Name something a beauty pageant contestant might wear.
Thinking of jewellery.
Yeah. You wear, you bling it up. You
That's
look
it.
Special when you got some Nick. Nice diamonds or something on.
Correct, yeah.
Jewellery for the win! Oh! Woohoo! Great chance now for you guys. Twin.
Lipstick for the big smile.
Nice. Look,
I was going to say lipstick as well.
You go with lipstick?
We're going with lipstick.
Marcel.
Yep.
Brian.
Well, everyone's gone lipstick.
It's quite a loud message down there, but don't let that put you off. You're the captain. You might have something amazing in that smiley face of yours.
Well, if I was a beauty contestant, I would wear lipstick.
You would, wouldn't you? You'd like that a little too much, wouldn't you?
You just especially picture one that has flavour.
Are you kissing yourself? You're practicing. What are we going with for the win here?
Lipstick.
We're going with lipstick? Yep. We ready to do this? Triple point round. Lipstick, is that number five? Yes. No, it's not. So the Parnabys are yet again out champs on Family Feud. Number five was... Riansyah family, everybody.
Ryan, Marcel, Lookman. Oh, man.
Do it, Lookman. Oh, there he is. Did you have fun, Ryan? We had fun having you. Of course, you didn't win tonight, but you won't go home empty-handed. We'll give you a gift card for $1,000 from eBay to spend at Australia's largest online shopping destination. So big thanks to eBay and a big thanks to these guys. Thanks for playing, guys. Great having you. Parnaby's fast money time. Ooh, a bit of a change in the order from Friday night. What's going on there?
You saw Friday night's episode.
I did actually. Brad's been sacked, Australia. Probably.
Hang my head in shame.
Not a bad read. Tried his hardest. Just didn't go that well.
No.
Let's do it tonight. $10,000. You're back that way, big fella. We do it. Fast money round. $10,000. It is 5 questions, 20 seconds next.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Welcome back to Fast Money Time here on The Feud. So let's see if the Parnaby family can win some cash. I'm sensing a little bit of sweet relief right now.
That was really hard. We thought we were gone.
You look concerned about the outcome of those few rounds, were you?
Yeah, we were.
Look, it's ended up being okay for you guys. So let's improve on how we went on Friday.
Yep. Definitely.
Now, if you and Travis get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000. Now, Travis currently in our soundproof booth, courtesy of Best and Less, and can't hear your answers right now. I'm going to ask you 5 questions and give you 20 seconds to answer. Now, if you pass, we'll come back if there's time. The clock starts at the end of the very first question. You ready?
Yep.
Okay, 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck.
Thank you.
Name something coin-operated.
Slot machine.
Name a part of the human eye.
The iris.
What's something you would see in a newspaper?
News.
Tell me something Eskimos do.
Freeze.
Name a famous pig.
Porky.
Porky Pig. Great job. With plenty of time to spare. Let's go. You played really well there. Have you been practicing?
Yes, we have. We had a 5-hour training session the other night behind the kitchen island bench. And we filmed it so we could critique our performance.
Really? You guys are really into this.
Yes, we are.
Oh, my goodness. Name something coin-operated, you said. A slot machine. Survey says. 9. We're on the board. Name a part of the human eye, you said. Iris. Survey says. 31. What's something you would see in a newspaper? You said, Der Grant, see news. Survey says. Fantastic. Tell me something Eskimos do. You said, they freeze. Survey says.
Yeah.
Name a famous pig. You said, Porky Pig. Survey says. Wow! Great finish, Sharon. Nice job. Practice is worth it. Travis,
Brian, how are you?
Welcome back. You need a total of 86 to get $10,000. Okay.
Sure.
I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions, but you're the second player. And it's a little trickier, so I'll give you an extra 5 seconds. Now, if you pass on a question, we'll come back if there's time. And if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound. And I'll ask you to try again. Can we remind everybody of Sharon's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. The time starts from the end of the first question. You set?
Cool.
Good luck.
Yep.
Name something coin-operated.
Pinball machine.
Name part of the human eye.
Retina.
What's something you would see in a newspaper?
Stories.
Tell me something Eskimos do.
a fish.
Name a famous pig.
Porky.
Try again.
Pig. No, it's got me.
It's when you hear that sound, it's really hard to recover from, isn't it?
It is, yeah, instant one that gets you, and then I think you got enough time, but it just beats you.
So. Oh, let's go. Let's see how you went. Travis. Righto. So we need to make this count from four. Four of your answers.
Let's do it.
Name something coin-operated. You said. A pinball is coin-operated. The survey says seven. Vending machine was the top answer. Name a part of the human eye. You said? The retina. Survey says 10. Sharon had iris. That was the top answer. We need 69 now for $10,000, and we need to do it from two questions. You're breathing deep.
Oh, it's nervous, Grant. Yeah.
You okay? You're not going to pass out on me, are you?
No, I'm fine. Let's do it.
What's something you would see in a newspaper? You said. Stories. Makes a lot of sense. Survey says.
Oh.
18. Sharon again had the top answer with news. So we need 51 from this last answer. Of course, you did not answer the last question, so let's rule that bottom one out. We need to make this one count. Tell me something Eskimos do is our final question that you answered. You said fish. How do you feel about that answer?
It's strong, but probably not quite there, Grant, to be honest.
Oh, your tone's just certainly just changed. Yeah.
No, it's there. Let's go. Come on.
51. Do we feel good about that answer? Imagine you could get the top answer, like, say, this. The survey says... And the final top answer was 4.